something for nothing scheme to feed to the frauds that got you locked up. Get in the car.
Quite comfortable there, are you?
Hello. So I've been looking at the Penguin books. I've taken all those out and was having a look through them this morning and a look online. So these came out in, they started in 1935, and the guy, I can't remember what his name was. I should have really wrote that down, but the guy started buying up publishing rights for some of these well-respected hardback books, and with a view to sell them as paperbacks for sixpence, I think they were. This is ninepence. This is 1939, this one. I think this is my earliest one. Or is it Literary Lapses? I think it's actually this one that's the earliest one I have. And they were sold for a sixpence. And the idea was that they were more available to lower earning and the masses, if you will. Sold in train stations and things like that. Everybody thought that it was a terrible idea because we had loads of pulp books, penny dreadfuls, yellowbacks, things like that beforehand that were selling well to the masses. And people thought that selling literature to them was a terrible idea. He went ahead and made these anyway, and he sold 63,000 copies to Woolworths, which was like a department store or shop chain back in the day. He sold 63,000 copies to them, and that basically paid for everything that he'd put down to start with, and he built his business on that sale. By the end of the year, he had printed and sold 1 million copies of just loads of different paperbacks. So he had The Orange, which was fiction. I've not got the full set. He had this kind of pink colour that I think is cerise, they call it, travel section. Blue, dark blue, which was biography. Green for crime. And, well, that's kind of it. And later on, this is a different style. There's brown here, which I think must have been classics or like ancient literature, I don't know, but this is brown, this one. They also, 1937, started the Pelican series, which was for non-fiction. I've got loads of those. Loads of them. And so this is what they were about. And yeah, it's gone from strength to strength ever since. Penguin are one of the big six, they're called, publishing houses. I think they've merged with Random House. Them and Simon & Schuster, I think, are the two biggest, and Macmillan. So yeah, there's those. I've got a few cool ones. Kind of the styles changed as they got later. They changed to this sort of style with a illustration, and then going even further into the 70s and 80s, they started doing painted covers. But the spine still denoting the fiction series and the text in the back on orange as well. But yeah, these are fantastic. I've actually found a copy online of one of the first, the original run that was made was 10 books, 7 of which were orange, I think, and 3 of them were, maybe 3 of them were biography, so they were the blue ones, but I found one of the blue ones, book 1 in the Penguin series, so I'm gonna be bidding on that. Hopefully we'll get it. But yeah, just wanted to show you some of these originals that I've got. I think these are all up to the 50s, so they must have been doing this style cover for about 20 years. H.G. Wells' History of Mr. Polly, 1984, by George Orwell. The Painted Veil by Somerset Maugham. The Trial, Franz Kafka. I got this recently. This is maybe this year. And The Great Gatsby, S. Scott Fitzgerald, I think that's it. Oh no, last one, The Diary of a Nobody. Now this was published in Punch magazine in 1888, around the same time, well in fact at exactly the same time that Jack the Ripper was murdering people in London. So I've got a copy of that down there with this book, Diary of a Nobody, serialised in it, and it's hilarious. It's hilarious and it's quite sad as well. I would really recommend finding this. It's a comedy, like written in like diary entries. But yeah, that's the penguin and the pelicans. We'll have a look at some of the older pelicans, because some of these themes are amazing. Here's one, Soviet science. Beyond the microscope. Where's that one I saw earlier? Ur of the Chalades. It's a archaeology book. This one's got pictures in it of the shit they found. So that's cool. What happened in history? This one. Physical basis of personality. British scientists of the 19th century. Plato and his dialogues. There's one of these on Stonehenge that I want to find. The Physiology of Sex. The philosophy and the Physicists. Genetics. And it must be cool to read these like with a knowing a basis. Like if you studied genetics, for example, reading this book from the 60s or something, and figuring out and like finding out what has changed since and what stayed the same. 1948 this book is. Metals in the Service of Man, that'll be interesting. And Famous American Men of Science. So yeah. And plus there's loads more. But that's Penguin and Pelican. I just wanted to have a look at that. Yeah, nice one. Hello. So we're in the middle of a storm just now. You can probably hear it raining. There's been lightning and stuff as well, but that's all gone just now. I just wanted to come in here and show you the chilies. They're looking pretty good. This one's actually flowering and fruiting. Don't know that you'll be able to see. There's a couple of flowers. They don't last long once they're whatever you call them, pollinated. And there's a chili in there. You can see a few. Yeah, this one looks like a flower is about to open tomorrow, maybe. So yeah, that's cool. It's been pissing down all day, so I've just been reading. I've reread The Woods Are Dark. I just wanted something to blast through, so that's what I've done. And now I'm reading Beware, which I've never read before. So that's what's happening there. We did have a look in the charity shops, but nothing was really happening. They don't seem to be putting out any new stuff. They're like only taking donations in on certain days and then not putting anything out. Doesn't really make much sense, but yes, oh, this isn't very good, is it? It's maybe better. So I've got one record today. This came in the post. It was at the start. There's a ghost in my house. I've been thinking about a Halloween playlist. I know I'm a bit jumping the gun a bit. But I'm thinking about a Halloween playlist for the radio show. The B-side on this is called Let's Go Somewhere. So that's what I've been doing. I've been listening to that. I've been listening to this guy, Carmen Cavallaro. He's from like the 30s, 1930s, I think. This album's called Music at Midnight. He's like a piano. I think it's like easy listening piano. It's pretty good when I'm listening, reading my book. I like that sort of thing. The BBC space themes. This is the theme show to a fair few of the BBC's TV shows. Plus, well, that's exactly what it is. It's just loads. And yeah, a couple of the tracks are written by the BBC. Some of them are just
like classical music, but some of them are written by the BBC. They've got this workshop called the Radiophonic Workshop, and they make all the sound effects and things. Those are the guys that make, I assume it's the same place. They make all these sound effect albums, but they also make music. They wrote the Doctor Who theme tune, for example. So yeah, that's pretty much what I've been doing. Is Finn in the back there? Yeah, there he goes. That parrot, it's a conure, it's called. His name's Xander.
Where's the creep that turned me into a spider-eating man-bitch?
And he just likes to chew shit. My headphones, my watch, my ear. He cleans my beard, which is helpful because I'm not particularly good at doing it myself. So yeah, that's pretty much everything. I'm just waiting to get back into this record shop in Aberdeen. Comic books I've been getting monthlies, but I've not even looked at a series for ages. I've just been reading the monthlies. And yeah, they're all trundling along. I don't even think I've got something new there. I think the next thing I'll get is this Tom King Rorschach, but we'll see. We'll see. I don't know if... Oh no, the death metal. I really like that. I really like that. So we'll see how that goes. But yeah, anyway, I'm literally just wittering on now. So yeah, not much happening this week. Maybe more exciting next week. And so yeah, we'll just see you then. Peace.